evening, everyone, from Veterans Stadium. Welcome to Phillies Baseball. Final game of the series, final game of the season series, the Bills and the San Francisco Giants. Another hot one here at the Vet tonight. Harry Callis with Chris Wheeler and Larry Anderson. Bills need a win to even the season series, but it was a great win last night, Wheels.
Well, Harry, that was one of those games with a lot of strategy. It was fun for us to do. Talked to Larry Bowe about that before the game. He says, well, I'm glad you guys had a lot of laughs, because I sure did last night, because it was a tough game to manage. He ran out of players early because the Phillies had their starter knocked out early. Then Ricky Ledeay tied the game with a pinch hit home run. Jimmy Rollins hit a home run to put him ahead. Here comes Barry Bonds with number 596. That ties it up, and Bonds would feature prominently later on in the ballgame. Sixth inning for the Phillies, two on, nobody out. Felix Rodriguez, great bunt by Doug Glanville that will set up the two runs that wins the ballgame. One of them right there on a wild pitch, and then a sacrifice fly by Jimmy as Marlin scores that run. Then in the ninth inning, Jose Mesa in a big jam strikes out Jeff Kent. And then Larry Bowa says, look, I know Jose wanted to pitch to him. I want to go out there and tell him, no way. Bonds wanted me to have him pitch to him. No way. They put him on. Bases are loaded. Put the lead run on. But then he gets Rich Aurelia to hit that breaking ball to left field. Larry Bowa says, you just can't do that very often, is put that lead man on. Little Jose having a good time with his dad there. He said, I'm not going to do that very often, but Barry Bonds is one of the few players in baseball, Harry, that'll make you do that. He says, but don't look for me to do that very often.
That's why the man has 42 intentional walks. In L.A., Randy Wolf pitching tonight. He has been pitching very well of late.
Well, I think he's been the Phillies' most consistent starter in a year that they haven't had a lot of consistency. He has really done a good job. Last six starts, he's got a 3-1 record, an ERA under 3. I mean, he's not giving up hits. His walks are down. He's getting a lot of strikeouts. He's just been very solid. In his last start against Atlanta, was using all of his pitches, both sides of the plate, did a great job, had some help defensively, gets a nice double play here off the bat of Chipper Jones, a nice turn by Jimmy Rollins. Then he helps himself on his chopper off the plate from Wes Helms. I mean, he really does a good job of helping himself, whether it's with the bat or with the glove. Gets Andrew Jones and a good fastball in on him for his sixth win. I mean, he has done a super job. The one thing Randy Wolf has been hurt by, one is his doing and one not. The first inning has always given him trouble. He needs to learn how to get out of that first inning better. But the other is a lack of run support, third worst run support in the National League, and he has nothing to do with that.
Randy Wolf will be on the mound for the Phillies. He will be opposed by Russ Ortiz for the San Francisco Giants. Wolf won't have to concern himself with Barry Bonds. Bonds is not in the lineup tonight. He's just taking it easy. We'll be back with the starting lineups right after these messages. Phillies baseball stadium. The Phillies have taken the field. Dusty Baker's starting lineup for San Francisco. Kenny Lofton, center field, leads off. Sean Dunston, left field, batting second. Rich Aurelia, shortstop, hits third. Jeff Kemp, first base, batting fourth. Benito Santiago, catching, hitting fifth. Reggie Sanders, right field, bats sixth. David Bell, third base, hits seventh. Ramon Martinez at second base will bat eighth. Russ Ortiz, the pitcher, hitting ninth. That lineup is facing 25-year-old Randy Wolf.
And Randy Wolf has been pitching very well lately. 20 starts overall, only a 6-7 record. A lot of that because he's had such poor run support. Third worst run support in the league. A lot of innings pitched, not many hits. Opponent's average of only 238. He is pitching with a lot of confidence now, and he's making his pitches, spotting the ball, and doing what he's got to do to give the Phillies a chance to win every time out. It was four starts versus the Giants, 2-1 with the 4.74.
Both his wins against San Francisco coming here at the Vet. At the Vet, he used 2-0 with a 2.77 ERA.
Much better here.
Kenny Lofton leads it off. He is 4-for-9 since joining the Giants. He is hit for the cycle. He has a single, double, triple, and home run for his four hits. Ron Culp of the plate umpire. Dale Scott at first. Jim Joyce at second. Jeff Nelson at third. One ball and one strike to Lofton. High fly ball, left field, tight to the line. Burrow runs out of room. And it's one ball and two strikes. 79th birthday wishes tonight to Bill Younger in North Wildwood, New Jersey, from wife Thelma, children and grandchildren, and from us to Bill Younger in North Wildwood. Gwen Lair of Roebling, New Jersey, celebrating a birthday wishes from husband Chris, daughter Jane, son CH, and from us to Gwen Lair. Bouncing ball up the middle, Jimmy Rollins. Play by J. Roll. That ball hit the cutout and kind of went down on him. Rollins makes the play. One down here in the first.
One thing Jimmy Rollins very aware of is the speed of Lofton. He knows he gets this ball, he's got to get rid of it. You see that ball hit right there in front of the cutout. He catches it and throws and has a lot on it. Nice scoop over there by Giambi.
Brings on Sean Dunston. Dunston hitting at 234. Has a six-game hitting streak coming into this one, hitting 429 in the last six. One strike. Russ Ortiz coming in after taking his warm-up tosses. Very warm night here at Veterans Stadium. The ball should carry well here tonight. 1-1.
Bud Smith pitched today for Scranton, one of the players that came over in the Scott Rowland trade. He pitched 6 1/3 innings in that game, gave up 6 hits, 3 earned runs. Only walked 1, struck out 5, allowed no home runs, but got a no decision in that game.
It was Roberto Zambrano who gave up 5 runs after Smith left the game. Smith pitched reasonably well. 1-2 to Dunston. 2-2. One out, no base runners. Fouled out of play. Was Pete Zamora, I'm sorry, not Roberto Zambrano. Pete Zamora that surrendered those 5 runs.
They had, I think, a 3-1 lead going into the seventh inning in that game. Red Barons did, but things kind of fell apart for them.
Got him with a curveball. Ball dropped by Lieberthal, but he tags out Sean Dunston, and that's out number 2 here in the first.
This is a good breaking ball by Randy Wolf, and Dunston will definitely chase. You see there, you get ahead of him and you can definitely get him out, get him to chase out of the zone. There's a Wolf pack here cheering on that first strikeout.
Wolf pack here again tonight, and it's great to see them in Cooperstown over the weekend. That was
that's pretty neat.
Yeah, that was very special. 1 strike to Rich Aurelia. Team innings, Cincinnati beat Los Angeles on Ken Griffey Jr.'s walk-off home run off Omar Dahl. Dahl was slated to pitch tomorrow night against the Phillies. That has been changed. It'll be Andy Ashby tomorrow. Another ex-Phil, opposed by Vicente Padilla.
Well, that game was really shouldn't have gone that long.
Dodgers went into the ninth inning with a 3-run lead. And their closer, Eric Gagne, hit a batsman, was ejected from the game.
That's ludicrous. Dan Iasagna felt that it was intentional. So he tossed him in a, what would have, at the time, a 1-run game in the ninth inning.
1-2 to Rich Aurelia. Breaking ball, foul back. Fire it, Birthday wishes tonight to Helen Van Sant, celebrating her 78th. Best wishes from her family, Nancy, Dale, Bruce, and Clark Kent Van Sant, and from us to Helen Van Sant on her 78th. Pretty well hit to center field. Ricky LeDay back to home plate. Out of here. Center field home run, Rich Aurelia. His ninth of the year. Just when it looked like Randy Wolf was going to get through first inning problems, Aurelia puts the Giants on the board.
1-2 count. He was one strike away from getting through that first inning. And he's going to try and come inside with his fastball, and you could see where Lieberthal's glove went, right in the middle of the plate down low. Randy Wolf obviously not happy with that.
16th home run he has surrendered. And as we mentioned, the ball is going to carry well here tonight. Here's Jeff Kent. Hitting 332, that's third best in the National League. Leads the league in hits with 136 of them. That's a towering drive to deep center field. LeDay at the warning track puts it away, and that will retire the side. Giants get a run on the homer by Aurelia. One hit, no errors, not much. After one half, it's San Francisco 1, and the Phillies are coming to bat. Winkers. Giants got a run on the top of the first. Phillies batting in the bottom half. Larry Boa's starting lineup for the Phillies. We'll have Ricky LeDay in center field leading off. Jimmy Rollins shortstop at second. Bobby Abreu right fielding third. Pat Burrell left field bats fourth. Jeremy Giambi first base hits fifth. Mike Lieberthal catching batting sixth. Placido Polanco at third base hits seventh. Marlon Anderson second base batting eighth. Randy Wolf the pitcher hits ninth. That lineup is facing 28-year-old Russ Ortiz.
And Russ Ortiz in 22 starts, a 7-7 record. He's been struggling lately, just having a hard time trying to figure out where he's throwing the ball. You can see from that spot right there from his stretch, he's not making a big circle. He's just taking the ball out of his glove and throwing it right from his ear. 64 walks for him, a lot of walks, and 135 innings. He can be very deceptive. He's got great stuff. I mean, this guy should be a 15-game winner every year with his stuff. Fastball 92 to 94, a little cut on the end of it. Got a good sharp curveball, and he also throws a changeup. Last time out, got knocked around pretty good. Gave up 8 runs in a couple of innings and walked 4.
Ricky LeDay, the first one to face him. One strike to LeDay. Ortiz won 17 last year, and the year before he won 18. In his first 3 years, he was a 49-game winner for the Giants, most by a Giants starter since Hall of Famers Gaylord Perry and Juan Marichal. Out of the University of Oklahoma, a fourth-round draft pick in the 95 draft. To the count to Ricky LeDay, who's batting at 225. He got the hit that got the Phillies back in it last night. A pinch hit, 3-run home run. His second pinch homer, that made it a 5-5 game, and that was big.
Now if you look at Ortiz, watch when he takes the ball right there out of his glove, and he just pulls it back about 10 inches. There's no circle. He makes no arc in his arm. And that is a lot of arm right there. That is, say, is not what you would want to teach a youngster. I don't remember him having such a short distance between where he takes the ball out of his glove and where he starts throwing the ball forwards to the plate. Wow, it's got to hurt.
2 balls and 2 strikes.
You see right there, he takes it out, and he just brings it right back and says he should be dropping that ball down by his side and taking it back and making a full arc. I guarantee he'd throw about 5 miles an hour harder.
2 balls and 2 strikes. Fastball getting up there about 92.
And that's all arm, too. That is, there's not a whole lot of the body or anything else being used with that from the way he takes that ball out of his glove and where he takes it, too.
Foul back and just below us. Birthday wishes tonight to Evelyn Kramer from husband Joe and from us. Full count holds to Ricky Lede. Bouncing ball chopped to third baseman Bell. Gets Lede by his stride. One down here in the bottom of the first. And it'll bring up Jimmy Rollins. Payroll hitting at 242. His ninth home run of the year here last night. It was his first Veterans Stadium home run this year. His eight previous homers hit on the road.
This was a bullet, too. He got a pitch down and in from Jensen trying to go away, and he ended up just dropping a bat hit on it and hitting a line shot out there.
One strike to Jimmy Rollins. One to J-Roll. Giants lead 1-0 on Rich Aurelia's home run. Keeps a foul out of play. Play of birthday wishes to Dan Sherman in Clementon, New Jersey. Celebrated yesterday. Wishes from his family. And Paul Krug also celebrated yesterday. Wishes from wife and friends in Deptford, New Jersey. Ground ball shortstop, Aurelia. Throws Rollins out, two down. And it'll bring up Bobby Abreu. Bobby hitting a 288. Walks, 72 walks, tied for six in the league in walks. He has good career numbers against Ortiz, a 444 lifetime hitter against his right-hander with two home runs. Strike to Abreu. Breaking ball, and he gets in front of him. No balls and two strikes. Line drive hit to right center field, locked and over quickly to cut it off. Abreu's going to try for two, and he's going to go in with a sliding double. Bobby's 33rd double of the year. Phillies lead the league in two base hits, and Abreu is second in the league in doubles.
Got a breaking ball there, hits in the gap. You could tell Kenny Lofton, the way he went over after it, he knew he was going to have to hurry. He tried to take it to the side, a backhand there, and plant and throw. But Bobby going hard the whole way, was looking double and got a double.
Abreu two behind Mike Lowell of Florida for the league lead in doubles. Burrell takes one low for a ball. Pat hitting at 283. Seventh in the league in homers with 26. Tied for fifth in RBIs with 75. Also among the league leaders in runs scored. He has not had success against Ortiz. 0 for 8 with 4 punchouts. At the end of the bat into shallow left field, Sean Dunstan comes on and then will retire the side. For the Phillies in the first. No runs, one hit. No errors, have one left at the end of one. San Francisco 1, Phillies nothing. This copyrighted telecast is presented by Authority. The Phillies may not be reproduced nor retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Phillies. 1-0 Giants. We go to the second inning. Benito Santiago leads off for San Francisco. He's hitting at 268. One strike to Santiago. Benito with 11 home runs. Fly ball right field, backtracking Abreu at the warning track, right in front of the fence, puts it away. I'm telling you, that ball is carrying in this heat.
Big time. He hits this ball pretty good, but a little towards the end of the bat, but it just keeps going and going and takes Bobby right back to the back of the warning track.
He's going to bring on Reggie Sanders. Sanders hitting at 258 with 14 homers, and this one is deep to right field. Bobby Abreu back. Puts it away. He's got him popping up, LA.
Yeah. Ballpark was built just big enough. Almost identical pitch, identical swing, and hit it about the same part of the bat. Bobby toying with that bullpen a little bit.
Two outs on two deep fly balls. Here's David Bell. And our best kid well wishes tonight to Bruce Oliver, a security supervisor here at Veterans Stadium, recouping at home in Horsham. Wishes from his co-workers and from us to Bruce Oliver. One on the count to David Bell. Door breaking ball and a beauty, one ball and two strikes.
That's that slow one. He'll throw a couple different ones. That one at 67. I've seen him throw a couple in the low 60s. And he'll throw it a little harder, sometimes in the low 70s.
Fouls off the fastball. And two. Birthday wishes to lead him, Smitty Smith of West Grove, Pennsylvania, celebrating his 76th from wife Joyce, daughters Susan, Linda, and Patricia. And from us to Smitty Smith in West Grove, PA. Bounces that curveball up there, 2-2.
Really, you're talking to Reggie Sanders about the swings they had.
Smothered it to third base. Polanco charges, throws out Bell, and then will retire the side. No runs, hits, errors, and none left after 1.5 at San Francisco 1, Phillies nothing. Giants, Jeremy Giambi will lead it off for the Phillies. Giambi hitting at 275 with 9 homers, 20 RBIs. Got a 598 slugging percentage and a 471 on-base percentage. One strike to Giambi. A little bit high. 75th birthday wishes to Ray Swigert in Goldsboro, Pennsylvania, celebrating on this 1st of August. Fouled in and out of the glove of Santiago. Late birthday to Michelle Cockrell of Swedesboro, New Jersey, from Mom, Dad, Bonnie, Jesse. Grandmom, Granddad, and Aunt Mary to Michelle Cockrell. Who almost got third base coach John Vukovich. It was right at him. Just smiling away.
He's looking. He usually gets a sign or two after something like that.
One ball and two strikes to Giambi. Marge Bidding of Douglasville, Pennsylvania, celebrating an 82nd birthday from friends Duke and Evelyn and from us. Him with a breaking ball. Giambi goes down swinging, the first strikeout for Ortiz. Well, the Dodgers will be moving in tomorrow night at 7:05. Vicente Padilla against Andy Ashby. Then Saturday is a 1:15 game. Nickelodeon SpongeBob SquarePants Day, Sunday at 1:35. All fans 14 and under get a Bobby Abreu replica jersey, compliments of Pico Energy. Monday at 1:05, our final Citizens Bank business person special, Pride of the Phillies posters featuring Vicente Padilla for all fans. Order your tickets for the Dodgers, 215-463-1000, or online at phillies.com. Mike Lieberthal hitting at 278. Swing the bat well of late, batting 348 in his last 19 games. Fouls this one out of play. Now balls and two strikes. Lillian Gralich of Philadelphia celebrating a 93rd birthday on this 1st of August. Phillies with a win last night. Ended with a winning record in July, 14-13.
Their home record with the win tonight would be at 500. They started off so well in the first month at home and disastrous on the road. It's kind of switched around now.
Oh, and two to Lieberthal with one out. One ball and two strikes.
Phillies started off 4-22 on the road. They're now 24-20 or 5-22. They're now 19-7 since then on the road.
That's a fair ball down the first base side. Fans do not interfere with it, and so Lieberthal will be held to a single. In that case, you kind of hope the fans would interfere with it.
You want them to, they don't. You don't want them to, they do. Well, that's just bad hands by that San Francisco Giant fan. had a high fastball cut away from him. He just hits it that way. He got a few of those pitches like that and fouled them off. This one, he keeps it fair.
Brings on Placido Polanco, who's hitting at 280 overall. Shot, base hit, center field. Libre follows stop at second. And the Phillies have two men on base with one out for Marlon Anderson.
And Polanco doesn't go up there and take a lot of pitches. He sees one he likes, he goes after it, and he usually hits the ball pretty hard. Hits this right up the middle, out of the reach of Martinez at second base.
So the Phillies with a threat here in the second. Two men on base, one out for Marlon Anderson, who's hitting at 279. Six homers, he has knocked in 37. He has good career numbers against Ortiz. He is 7 for 17 lifetime against Russ Ortiz. Strike to Marlon. And our best to Lee Harvey in Audubon, New Jersey. Used to work for the Phillies, was with the Phillies organization for 33 years. Those catches are telecasts and broadcasts. Very best to Lee Harvey in Audubon. On one the count to Marlon Anderson. To third base, they might turn a double play, and they do. So Marlon grounds into a 5-4-3 double play, and that will retire the side. No runs, two hits, no errors, one left. We go to the third, 1-0 San Francisco. Time now for the Dodge Stump the Fans trivia question. Log on to Phillies.com. If you're the first to correctly answer, you'll win two tickets to a Phillies game. Please submit your answer in the subject area. You must leave your name and address to receive your prize. Tonight's Dodge Stump the Fans trivia quiz. Who was the last National League batter to hit 400 in a season? Answer and winner will be revealed in the seventh inning. Ramon Martinez leads it off for San Francisco. Second baseman hitting at 271. Giants lead 1-0 here in the third. Dorothy Cleveland of Locust Gap, Pennsylvania, celebrating a 90th birthday. Wishes from her family and from us. One to Martinez. Missed with a curveball, two balls and a strike. 80th birthday wishes to Leo Stenson in Glen Olden, Pennsylvania. Wishes from Leo's family and from us. Change up, he got it over. Two balls and two strikes to Ramon Martinez. Fouls this one back and out of play. Two it holds to Martinez. Back through the middle, that'll be in the center field for a base hit for Ramon Martinez. Second hit given up by Wolf. Phillies offer all sorts of incentives for bringing a group to a ball game here at the Vet. Bring just one group of 25 or more, you'll get 2 free tickets to go along with your group. Bring a second, you'll receive a limited edition Larry Boa bobblehead. Many group incentives. Call the Phillies sales office at 215-463-5000 and get all the information about coming to the ballpark in a group. Russ Ortiz around a bunt, bunting foul, one strike to Ortiz. Ortiz not a bad hitting pitcher. He's hitting at 214. He has hit a home run. It came off Terry Mulholland to the Dodgers. Lifetime, he's hit 3 home runs. He has 2 sacrifices. One on the count to Ortiz. Look at Sonny Jackson, the third base coach for Dusty Baker. You have to be leery that he could take the bunt off and let him swing. So you don't want to just lay it in there. Lifetime Ortiz is a 207 hitter. Was still on. Wolf misses with it. 2 balls and a strike. Just missed. Wolf has fallen behind Ortiz. 3 balls and a strike.
I guess he called that low. Dusty Baker goes through the signs. It's on the plate.
Gets the bunt down. Randy Wolf takes the out at first base. Sacrifice good by Ortiz. Luis Martinez is second.
Well, earlier today, the Philadelphia A's Historical Society presented this painting to Harry. Great artist Stan Kotsen did it. All your broadcast partners over the years, H.
Yeah, that was really very, very nice. Paisam up on the upper left hand, Whitey, Wheels, and Andy, Scott, and you, and Tom McCarthy on the bottom there.
That is really nice.
Yeah, very nice. Kenny Lofton takes it just a little bit low. 1 ball and no strikes.
Might have to build an addition.
Really? Breaking ball, he laid off it. 2 balls and no strikes to Lofton. Lofton grounded to short his first time up. Philly Fanatic.
Always entertaining.
Was in Cooperstown this weekend. Fanatic's uniform. It's enshrined at the Hall of Fame.
I can't help. Every time I look at him, I just laugh.
3-0 here to Lofton. At the fastball over, 3-1. Big game for the Giants, who, with the Dodgers' loss today, are now just a half a game behind in the wild card race.
You can see after the game last night, Santiago and Kent sat in the dugout just kind of staring out, frustrated. It's when you're in a race, it's something.
First walk given up by Wolf puts 2 men on base with 1 out for Sean Dunston. Dunston struck out his first time up. It's that kind of night. Randy Wolf has something as high besides perspiration. Talk walking it over with two men on base and one out. Wolf will try to get a ground ball here. Bounces the curveball up there, one ball and no strikes.
Randy Wolf, not really known as a ground ball pitcher, but he's been successful more than you would think in getting double plays. One every eight opportunities, 7.8.
Dunston beats it foul, 1-1. Good to see Patricia Hubick of Wilmington, Delaware in attendance tonight. Loyal Phillies fan. Martinez at second, Lofton at first, one out here in the third inning. And a strike to Sean Dunston. Curveball, he beats it foul. One ball and two strikes.
Even though that curveball was up a little bit, it had pretty good rotation, pretty good bite to it. Dunston kind of came out of his shoes, thought he had a pitch to hit, and that ball just kind of bottomed out right at the end.
So Randy Wolf ahead on the count. Struck him out with a fastball. He has two strikeouts, and Dunston has been the victim both times. One down here, two down here in the third.
Well, he got him the first time on a curveball that bounces. Wolf Peck gets into it. And this one, a high fastball. Off the plate, goes after it out of the zone.
And that'll bring on the man that hurt Randy Wolf. His first time up, a center field home run, accounting for the lone run of this game, Rich Aurelia. Wide, one ball and no strikes.
First inning, he wanted a fastball in, and he left it right in the middle of the plate. It was down, but Aurelia got the bat head on it. Hit it out to dead center. Ball really carrying tonight.
Drop the curveball in there for a called strike. 1-1 the count to Aurelia. Move in tomorrow night for a four-game series. Tomorrow a night game and then three straight day games, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Was Aurelia didn't get it. One ball and two strikes.
Randy Wolf really tied him up inside. A good fastball. Right on by Aurelia in a good spot.
Wolf ahead, a ball and two strikes. Third strike, painted the inside corner, struck him out. Third strike out for Wolf, and that's it for the Giants. No runs, a hit, no errors. They lead two. We go to the bottom half of the third inning. Giants 1, Phillies nothing. That is 1-0 San Francisco. Randy Wolf will lead it off for the Phillies. Crowd on hand for this final game with the Giants. Dodgers move in for 4 beginning tomorrow night.
Young Phillies fan, a couple of them.
Wolf hitting at 167, 6 for 36. Actually pinch hit in last night's game. One strike to Randy Wolf. Wide, 1 ball and 1 strike. To the screen, 1-2. High, 2-2. Ortiz lifetime has a good winning percentage. He is 60-41 lifetime. Ground ball shortstop, Rich Aurelia. Throws out Wolf, 1 down. Time now for tonight's Citizens Bank, Not Your Typical Fan. Each game will scan the crowd to find a fan or fans who set themselves apart from the rest. Those are not your typical fans.
I knew. I saw that guy down in the stands earlier. That's not a real pretty shot.
That guy's up there with a wolf pack. Here's Ricky LeDay, grounded out his first time up. And out in front of a changeup.
Trying to make his way into that tribe.
One ball and one strike to Ricky LeDay. LeDay's legions are here tonight also. One and two to LeDay. There they are. Still a ball and 2 strikes. Giants 1, Phillies nothing.
There are a few legions out there.
Levy's legion. LeDay's legion. Next, it'll be Lily's Legion. Yeah. 2 balls and 2 strikes.
He's looking for a Legion.
It's high and it's full count. Jimmy Rollins waiting on deck. Cubs came back to beat the Padres this afternoon at Wrigley 8-7. They were down in that game late. Came back in the late innings. In the American League, Toronto beat Kansas City in a day game 3-2 today. The LeVay goes down swinging. Second strikeout for Ortiz. And we'll pause for station identification on the Phillies Television Network.
You're watching UPN 57 WPSG-TV in Philadelphia.
Friday, August 16th will be a big night here. Plan to come early. We have the Alumni Batting Challenge. Mike Schmidt, Greg Luzinski, and Tug McGraw will take on Darren Dalton, John Kruk, and Milt Thompson in this year's Batting Challenge. Always a great event here at the Vet. We'll start at 6:30 with the game at 7:05. Order your tickets by calling 215-463-1000 or online at Phillies.com. St. Louis Cardinals will be in that night. Jimmy Rollins grounded out his first time up. Off-speed pitch for a strike. What a wonder, Rollins. Center field, it hangs up. Reggie Sanders gingerly going after it. He's bothered with a hamstring, but he had plenty of time to make the grab. No runs, hits, errors, none left. Chris Wheeler joins Larry Anderson the fourth after 3-1-0 San Francisco.
Wolf giving up one run tonight. The Giants have hit a home run the first inning all three games of this series. Richard really in the first inning tonight. Well, that's where the game stands, 1-0.
50 pitches now for Randy Wolf. Pretty good ratio. Strikes to balls.
Jeff Kent will lead it off out of the four hole. And he swings and misses. Benito Santiago on deck. And then Reggie Sanders, all right-handed batters. Only left-handed hitter in the lineup tonight is Lofton. Kent hit a fly ball to center his first time up. Swing and a miss at a breaking ball. It looked like after all those track balls they were hitting off fastballs, and they decided to mix them up a little more.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea.
Boy, at BP, it was just flying out of here all over the place. Winds have died down a little bit now as we look at the flags atop the stadium. Good Barry Bonds, he'd like to be hitting on a night like this. And a hard ground ball to second. Marlins right there. And over to Jeremy Giambi. One out. BPS number 5, the final one of the year. That will be on Monday when the Phillies play the Dodgers at 1:05. And don't forget, this year's Pride of the Phillies poster will be given away that day. It is of Vicente Padilla. We saw that today, and it's really terrific. So you'll want to pick that up when you come out here on Monday against the Dodgers, the final game of the series, final game of the homestand. And it's compliments of our good friends at Citizens Bank, 215-463-1000, anytime online, phillies.com. Here's Benny. Santiago hit a deep fly ball his first time up. He didn't like that. He thought that was a little high. Gives a home plate umpire Culpa a look and has something to say to him. Ageless Benito Santiago. All-star. He didn't like that one either. And he's in the hole 0-2. Says, man, I'm back there behind the plate. My guy's not getting those. Better not call strike three on him.
Oh.
Blowing in the dirt, 1-2. And a new baseball on its way. Benito giving Culpa a little look there, laughing with Lieberthal. Benny was around when the Phillies were developing Mike Lieberthal, so they know each other. He helped bridge the way to the major leagues for Mike. And a little jammer, but Marlins playing in shallow right field, and he's there and makes the play, two outs. And Santiago will have something to say to Culpa, I think, as he walks past him. Yep. Man, he'll have plenty of time to talk to the home plate umpire.
He's got a little grin.
Well, Benny's funny. You know, you've been around that guy. He's a good teammate when he was here with the Phillies, and I'm sure the Giants enjoy having him around. Reggie Sanders flying out to deep right his first time up. And a hard ground ball on one hop. Jimmy Rollins wheels, throws. Sanders can't run at all with that hamstring problem, so he's out by a lot. And Randy Wolf has his second 1-2-3 inning. No runs, no hits, there's nobody left. It's 1-0 Giants.
This is Jose Mesa.
And I'm Jose Jr. In English, our name means Joe Table.
Jimmy Rollins.
In Spanish, his name is Jimmy Footstool.
Vicente Padilla.
His name means blazing fastball.
Pat Burrow.
His name means stud muffin.
Mike Libertad.
See Schmidt, Lazinski, Dalton, and more Friday, August 16th at the Alumni Batting Challenge. Or join us on Sunday, August 18th for the Harry Callis Tribute. Call now.
Great timing by our producer, John Slabak, and of course, to bring Bobby Abreu up after that spot. Burrow and Giambi to follow. Left, right, left to face Russ Ortiz. Yeah, I saw you showing a close-up of Ortiz early on. We were talking about on radio. Did he always hook the ball that way behind his ear?
John Slabakin, our producer, showed me a tape of his last start in May. Kruko's the one, their broadcaster, Mike Kruko, former Phil's, the one that mentioned it to me. And I never really noticed from this angle that the way he took the ball back, he just brings it back like right to his ear like a catcher almost.
Yeah.
Doesn't make a long arm arc or circle. But, looking at his prior start against the Phillies back in May, it was very similar. There's Kruko.
Yeah, it just seemed to jump out tonight. Bobby swings and misses. He has a live arm.
But it hurts to watch it.
Yeah.
I really think Kruko, I asked him about it actually after the first inning, and he said, he plays catch with it, trying to make a bigger arm arc. This is back on May 1st. He's still kind of the same thing.
That looked like it was a longer arm arc.
A little bit, yeah.
I mean, this looks like it's much closer to his body. Burrow rips it foul down the third baseline. Well, it works for him. I'm sure you wouldn't want to teach that because it looks like an arm injury waiting to happen.
Now, this is tonight. The pitch he struck Bobby Abreu out on. See how he just brings it straight back? He never brings it below his shoulder.
Yeah.
Which is really different.
This guy's been a tremendous pitcher for them. I mean, he's 19 games over 500 as he pushes Burrow off the plate with a good fastball. Struggling a little bit this year since the All-Star break, but we've rarely seen him have a bad outing. Pat chases a high pitch there and a fly ball to left center. Center fielder Lofton didn't see it, but Dunston did and came in and caught it. You could see Lofton was in no man's land there. He didn't know where that ball was. And they're talking about it right now, Lofton and Dunston. It's about that time of the night right now, kind of a weird sky with a few clouds.
Two pitches and an excellent ratio for Ortiz.
Phillies with three hits off him and a 1-0 ball game. They've out hit the Giants 3-2, but the home run the difference in the game by Aurelia. Jeremy takes it low. He struck out his first time up after whistling a foul ball over John Vukovich's head. Ball down the left field line. It's carrying well near the corner. Dunston right there and makes the play. So three up and down go the Phils. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. 2-4, 1-0 Giants. Pitching here tonight, totals almost even, but the Giants have a run on Rich Aurelia, solo home run, his ninth of the year, with two outs in the first inning. Randy Wolf done a really good job. So is Russ Ortiz. Lede and Rollins 0-6 tonight at the top of the order. And a bunch of strikeouts, 10 for these two pitchers, 5 apiece. There's one on Dunston by Randy Wolf. Called strikeout on Aurelia, and then he gets Reggie Sanders looking on a fastball. And as for Russ Ortiz, breaking ball to Giambi. Breaking ball to Abreu and breaking ball to Jimmy Rollins. All the strikeouts on breaking balls in that sequence. David Bell will lead it off out of the seven hole for play-by-play. Here's Harry.
All right, thank you, Wheels. Bell fouls off the first pitch. One strike to him. Bell has grounded out and he has popped up. Then Ramon Martinez and Russ Ortiz. Curveball nubs softly to Jimmy Rollins. J-Roll throws him out. That's one down. Phillies Festival, which used to be known as the Phillies Autograph and Auction Party, will be held this year Monday, August 19th for the fight against Lou Gehrig's disease. On-field fun, autograph booths, Ozzie Smith and Dutch Dalton will be on hand, as will Greg Luzinski, all for a great cause. For the ALS Association Greater Philadelphia Chapter, order your tickets by calling 215-463-1000. Mark the date down on your calendar, Monday, August 19th, here at the Vet. Here's Ramon Martinez. He is singled and grounded out. He has one of the four hits off Randy Wolf, and he pops him up behind first base. Marlon Anderson puts that one away. Two quick outs for Wolf here in the seventh inning, and they'll bring on Russ Ortiz. Ortiz has one of the four giant hits. He has sacrificed and singled. Pretty good hitting pitcher. He has homered this year off Terry Mulholland. Lifetime, he has three home runs in his career. Starting with a fastball for a strike. Nothing in one to count to Russ Ortiz here in the seventh inning. Change up, miss low, 1-1. Another change up, just beat it foul. One ball and two strikes to Russ Ortiz. Two outs and no base runners here in the seventh inning. Fastball, he fouls it back and out of play. Still 1-2 to Ortiz. Skip memory lane. Clayton dropping that foul ball, as you can hear the fans' reaction. There's a bouncing ball chopped to third base. Polanco has it. Low throw, and it's going to be an error on Placido Polanco. Giambi could not dig it out. So Polanco commits his first error as a Philly. And Ortiz is at first base, and the batter will be Kenny Lofton. Just took too much time and tried to guide the throw and bounced it up there. So here is Kenny Lofton. Blanco's seventh error this season, his first as a Philly. Lofton is grounded out, walked and singled. One strike to Kenny Lofton. A pause for station identification on the Phillies Television Network.
You're watching UPN 57 WPSG-TV in Philadelphia.
Nothing in one to Kenny Lofton. Curveball, big hack, no contact, no balls and two strikes. Randy Wolf is right at the 100 pitch mark tonight. 68 strikes, good strikes, balls ratio. He's pitched very well, but once again, the Phillies have trouble scoring runs for Randy. He trails 1-0. Drop down on Lofton, and he smokes it to left field. Burl, a long run, makes the running grab right near the foul line to retire the side. No runs, no hits, one error, one left. Stretch time, we go to the bottom of the seventh. Giants 1, Phillies nothing. Card Stump the Fans trivia quiz tonight. Who was the last National League batter to hit 400 in a season? Well, the answer, Phil Terry of the 1930 New York Giants. He hit 401. First Phillies fan with a correct response was Kyle Jordan of Coatesville, Pennsylvania. Congratulations, Kyle. You're the winner of two tickets to an upcoming Phillies game. Thanks for playing Dodge Stump the Fans. Well, bottom half of the seventh inning. A couple of bobbleheads. Giants lead this one 1-2-0. Jeremy Giambi will lead it off. Once again, Wheels, the Phillies have trouble getting any runs to Randy Wolf. It's amazing.
How about none tonight? Some of the worst run support in the league, but to his credit, he's gone out there and just kept pitching. You mentioned, Harry, he's 100 pitches or more now, so they would love to get in this spot in the order and hit for him in this inning and try and get some runs.
Jeremy Giambi has struck out and flied out to deep left field.
Give Russ Ortiz some credit, too. He's been terrific here tonight. Can't imagine him having a line like he had against the Dodgers last time out, because we never see that with this guy. He always pitches well. Seems like it anyway.
One ball and one strike to Giambi.
There's Randy Wolf due to bat fifth in this inning with Todd Pratt.
Hit right field. Jeremy Giambi starts it out with a single to right. Hit number five for the Phils, and that'll bring up Mike Lieberthal.
He got jammed with a slider there, something off speed in. It is a breaking ball. You see, he pulls his hands in, gets jammed a little bit, fights it off, and they're going to bring Doug Glanville out now to run for it. Reggie Sanders gets it back in.
So Glanville, the pinch runner at first base. Mike Lieberthal has singled and popped up.
Larry Ball, this is a tribute to Russ Ortiz as much as anything, just saying, hey, I got to try and get something here. So he brings in a pinch runner in the seventh inning.
Terry Adams gets up in the Phillies bullpen.
That's interesting. Before the game, Bo said, I don't think I can use him tonight. He said he thought he'd be able to use Timlin, but not Adams after two innings apiece.
Doug Glanville has stolen 11 bases. He's only been thrown out once.
He's stolen 10 in a row. Mike's been having trouble staying off high pitches tonight from Ortiz, even though he did tomahawk one down the line for a base hit in right field.
Last thing Boa wants to see in this situation is a ground ball.
Yep.
And Ortiz keeps an eye on Doug Glanville at first. Benito Santiago, the catcher, has thrown out 31% of base dealers this year. The ground ball, but it's up the middle. Base hit center field. The Phillies have their first two men on base here in the seventh.
Well, you're right.
Past Ortiz.
You're right, unless you can shoot one right out of the pitcher's glove. Ortiz has that little bemused smile because he probably thinks he should have caught that. He's a really good fielder. Made a good play earlier. Slider away, and just a little late getting the glove down and a base hit for him. Mike Lieberthal and the Phillies, for only the second time tonight, put two men on base.
And you kind of figure Placido Polanco will be bunting here. He's talking it over with John Vukovic. He has been good at sacrificing. He has made 9 sacrifices this year while with the Cardinals. And meanwhile, the Giants will converge on the mound. Dave Righetti, the pitching coach out there, to decide how they are going to play a possible bunt here from Polanco. Even Phillies, though it's the tail end of the order, the Phillies would hit, of course, for Randy Wolf.
Right. And the Giants know that they have a fast runner at second base to the Phillies, so this isn't a situation where you try to do anything real cute, I wouldn't think. And they're Russ start, or the comparison there for Russ Ortiz, we mentioned the last start he had, and what a difference tonight.
Polanco has singled and grounded back to the mound.
Placido wants to make the third baseman field this.
Ortiz safe at third base. Ortiz makes a mistake, as Wheels just pointed out. Glanville's speed. Anybody else there, or almost anybody else there, and he's got the force at third. But Glanville, a superb job in getting from second to third and beating the throw.
Ortiz, I mentioned, is a really good fielder, but it's just not a good play. You know, you've got a good base runner at second base, and you just have to get the out there, and the Phillies get a big break. Bell did retreat in time, but the throw was wide, and Glanville beats it, and now they're set up for a big inning, except for this bases loaded stuff, which has been getting better lately.
They are loaded with nobody out. Marlon Anderson, Tomas Perez moves into the on-deck circle as Tim Worrell gets up in the San Francisco bullpen. Anderson is grounded into a double play and walked. One ball and no strikes.
Well, they just need to get something here now. Obviously, they would love to take a lead. Tomas Perez out there to bat for Randy Wolf. We talked about that at the start of the inning, how good it would be if they could get to that spot and hit for Wolf.
On the outside corner, one ball and one strike to Marlon Anderson. Glanville at third, Lieberthal at second, Polanco at first. Nobody out here in the seventh.
Giants are going to play that infield a double play depth. They'd gladly give up a run here for two outs.
Almost a wild pitch. A good catch by Santiago.
He's still really good back there. That was a tough play. Fastball. Sinker. And Benny shifted really well on it. Didn't even have to block it. He caught it.
Two and one to Marlon Anderson. Bouncing ball chopped to second base. They're going to get one. They're not going to get a double play. And Glanville scores. And this game is tied at 1-1. With runners at first and third. Doug Glanville scoring the runs, and Doug has come in and done a great job off the bench the last two nights, getting a great bunt down and then getting from second to third on a bunt.
Nice play by Martinez. It really probably shouldn't have thrown this because Anderson was going to beat it easily. But at least they get the game tied, and now they'll shift the pinch hitter to Travis Lee as Randy Wolf will get a no decision and possibly a chance to win the ballgame.
Travis Lee will pinch hit for Randy Wolf. Looking for a fly ball here. Travis Lee hitting at 253. Eight homers. He's knocked in 43. He is 3-for-7 as a pinch hitter. And he'll try to get a fly ball deep enough to allow Lieberthal to score from third base.
Terrific job by Randy Wolf again tonight. Dusty Baker there. His team's a pretty good defensive team, too. And then head fielder's sacrifice, fielder's choice. Joe LaFay, former Phillies player, now one of their coaches. Dave Righetti on the bench there. One of Joe LaFay's best buddies, 50 years old today, Gigi, Greg Gross. Happy birthday to him.
Really? Gigi's 50th.
Yep. He's taking a little heat about that before the game.
Beats the ball foul. One strike to Travis Lee.
threw him a sinker there. As Harry said, he's trying to hit a fly ball, Travis Lee, and give the Phillies their first lead of the game. And Russ Ortiz wants to throw a sinker and get a double play. And once again, David Bell, the third baseman, against all these left-handed hitters of the Phillies, they play him way off the line. Really hard to get a hit in the hole on the left side for a left-handed hitter against his defense.
Andy Wolf, 101 pitches, 7 great innings, 4 hits, 1 run, 5 strikeouts, 1 walk. And his mates trying to give him the lead here in the 7th. Lino is in the hole, no balls and 2 strikes. Nothing and 2 to Travis Lee.
Another sinker.
Santiago, so he just has life. Still nothing in the 2.
Ortiz is making really good pitches here. Sinker, 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 all away and just off Benny's glove. Here's another look at it. You see where that sinker is away? Those are strikes, too. Perfect pitches. Nothing there that you can lift, that's for sure.
0-2 to Travis Lee. Too far away. 1 ball and 2 strikes.
Chad Zerbe up. Tim Worrell. Zerbe the left-hander. Worrell a right-hander. Still have not seen them in this series, which has been nice.
Little dribbler. Play at the plate, no chance. Lieberthal scores. That's going to be an interesting scoring decision. I don't know if they would have had Lee at first base. A swinging bunt, and does it pay off? Phil's lead 2-1.
Well, they're really giving Ortiz a butt kicking in this inning.
Yeah.
Some misplays, some little ground balls, but the key, Harry, is contact. No strikeouts. A good sinker he throws. Travis makes contact. As you say, the only play, really, he comes home. I mean, if he pivots and throws, you could see Martinez was covering first, but that would have been a tough play, too. They'll just call it a fielder's choice RBI. Good base running by Lieberthal. Got an excellent walking lead and a good break off third.
Well, the Phils have taken a 2-1 lead. And the batter is Ricky Lede, who's grounded out, struck out, and grounded out. Cues a ground ball to third base. This might be a double play and is around the horn double play. But the Phils put 2 on the board here in the 7th. They do so with 2 hits and a few fielder's choices. No errors, 1 man left. We go to the 8th, 2-1 Phillies. In the game to play center field. Travis Lee stays in the game to play first base. And Terry Adams is the new pitcher for the Phils. Adams trying to get anything in here for Larry Boa. Moved out of the starting rotation. This is his 5th game out of the bullpen. He's had 19 starts, 4-7, 4.76 ERA. 107 and 2/3 innings, 112 hits, 52 earned runs. He struck out 73, walked 48. Opponents hitting 271 against him, and he'll be facing Sean Dunston, Rich Aurelia, and Jeff Kemp.
What a different bullpen for the Phillies now. As they start the inning with Adams, they have the veterans Timlin and Plesac up. A different look and a lot of experience.
Plesac and Timlin. Phils leading 2-1. And strike. Dunston. Somebody made a good catch out there. Looked like that Dennis Deitch. that ball on the fly. One strike to Sean Dunston. A bottom one strike.
Sean Dunston dives in everything. That pitch probably wasn't as close as he even thought it was, but he's going to make sure he got his coconut out of there.
Fly ball center field. Doug Glanville has it lined up. One down here in the eighth inning. And it'll bring on Rich Aurelia.
Here's the home run by Rich Aurelia in the first inning. Randy Wolf with a fastball out over the plate a little bit and a bomb to dead center field. And Randy Wolf was so good here again tonight. After that home run, nothing. And gave his team a chance, and they scratched out a couple runs in the seventh and now lead by one.
And you would assume that Barry Bonds might be available to pinch hit here in the late innings.
Oh, yeah. You know Boa keeps looking out of the corner of his eye over there. He knows he's not going to hit for these two guys, Aurelia and Kent.
Right. Bouncing ball, chopped to third base. Placido Polanco throws and gets him. That's two quick outs for Terry Adams. And it'll bring on Jeff Kent.
This is amazing for Terry Adams tonight. But I mean, before the game, Bo really did not think that Adams could go back-to-back at this point, especially after two innings. But obviously, they talked about it, and Adams felt he could go tonight. I'll have to talk to Bo about that later and see what changed his mind.
You never know. Maybe Terry Adams changed his mind.
Well, Terry Adams wants to do this right now. I mean, he wants to be a starter, Harry. You know, we were talking about that with him the other day. But he is now settling into this role.
Lofted tight to the line and right. Abreu was way off the line, but it's a foul ball. Caught by that young man.
Adams' old team in town. Probably the Dodgers are here by now after that long game today. And Adams a starter for them for half of the year last year, and then a starter for the Phillies this year, and now back in the bullpen.
And won the count to Jeff Kent.
Phillies have Polanco guarding the line at third.
Hits it in the hole, base hit left field. Kent. So he's a two-out base runner for Benito Santiago.
Jeff Kent, third leading hitter in the league coming into the game, a high sinker, and he just whacks it in the hole for a base hit.
Santiago's fly to deep right. He has popped up and struck out.
And there's Bonds with the bat just in case. And they have Polanco even further on the line now for Santiago to stay away from an extra base hit. There's Bo taking a look over there at Bonds. And Bonds is telling him, I'm ready. See, they're having a little fun. Bo's saying, I ain't gonna pitch to you tonight.
And if he would come out there, he has Dan Plesac ready.
Plesac does not have real good lifetime numbers against Bonds. Plesac really good against left-handed hitters, most of them, but not Bonds.
Barry's just 7 for 18 off him.
That's not good.
Yeah.
Couple bombs in there.
Couple bombs. One ball and no strikes to Santiago. Beats a foul, 1-1.
Bowen Bonds had a little fun at the cage before the game tonight when Barry came out of the dugout saying, you know, you're not pitched to me last night. I mean, you know, and Bo was just, you got to be kidding me thinking I pitched to you. It was a great moment, that ball game.
Yeah, it sure was. Exciting game. Kind of a slugfest last night, much different tonight.
You remember when Jim Fregosi was here? I mean, Bonds would leave the on-deck circle, and Jimmy'd have four fingers
up. Oh, yeah.
I mean, that got to be a real routine.
Ooh. One ball and two strikes to Santiago.
Adams got that pitch up. This was not a good pitch here, and he got away with one. You see Santiago, a high sinker, and he had a rip at that and fouled it back.
We're in the eighth. Phil's on top by a score of 2-1.
Mentioned Polanco guarding the line at third where the outfielders are in that no doubles defense. Very deep. See them out there trying to prevent any kind of extra base hit here.
Two balls and two strikes.
Adam just looked like he overthrew that sinker a little bit, and sometimes that'll keep a ball up. His ball has real good movement down. And that's what he's just trying to get here is his final out of the inning.
Fly ball into center field. Doug Glanville has it lined up. Glanville squeezes. That'll retire the side. No runs, one hit. No errors, one left. We go to the bottom of the eighth. It's the Phillies 2 and San Francisco 1. Toyota American League scoreboard. Toronto edged Kansas City this afternoon 3-2 as Roy Halladay won his 13th game. Baltimore 4-1 over Tampa Bay. That game in the seventh behind Sidney Ponson. Jake Gibbons is his 20th homer. Minnesota shutting out the White Sox 5-0 in the fifth behind Eric Milton. Texas knocked out John Burkett of the Red Sox in the second inning. They lead 13-1. John Hope Park getting all those runs. Yankees and Anaheim later. Detroit at Oakland and Cleveland at Seattle. All will start later. Here we're in the eighth inning. The Phillies lead it by a score of 2-1. And leading off for the Phillies, Jimmy Rollins. He is 0-3 and he fouls one straight back. One strike to Rollins.
Jose Mesa up in the Phillies bullpen. They'd love to get another one here. So if there is a tightrope act in the ninth inning, you have a little margin for error. There is Jose.
And you know that Barry Bonds will come out at some point. Just missing one ball and one strike.
Well, you would think so. I mean, unless it's a deep that he's there with that bat and ready to come out. I think they would use him in that ninth inning. There he is with Dave Rigetti.
One and two the count to Jimmy Rollins.
Boy, Ortiz has pitched some game here tonight. Randy Wolf and Ortiz have been tremendous pitching. And a fine setup inning there by Terry Adams.
Line drive into center field, but playing him shallow was center fielder Kenny Lofton. He makes the grab. So Rollins is out, one down. Well, tomorrow it'll be Vicente Padilla, Phillies all-star pitcher going for the Phils, and a former Phil, Andy Ashby, will be on the mound for the Los Angeles Dodgers. We'll be on Comcast Sportsnet at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. Back on UPN 57 on Sunday against the Dodgers at 1:30 with Phillies Weekly and Ron Burke at 1 o'clock.
In the ninth inning for the Giants, scheduled to bat Reggie Sanders, David Bell, Ramon Martinez, and then Ortiz's spot. And they got some thunder off the bench from the left side. There's another one, JT Snow. They also have Ryan Miner and, of course, Mr. Bonds.
One ball and no strikes to Bobby Abreu, who is 2-for-3, is doubled, struck out, and singled.
So it should be a very interesting ninth inning.
And the Phils would like to give Mesa more than a one-run lead to work with in the ninth inning with all those left-hand bats on the bench. But Jose will have his work cut out for him.
And it looks like Nen is up in the bullpen. We mentioned he has not been in this series. Oh, it's Worrell. You do not want to get Nen into this series.
Worrell's up in case Ortiz would have a little trouble here in this inning, get a couple of men on base. Ortiz has pitched very, very well. Obvious call for a swing by the plate umpire, Ron Culpum. 2-2.
Ortiz has really had a good sinking fastball tonight, too. That was one there, a two-seamer. He's had a good curveball, a four-seamer once in a while, but mostly sinker and breaking ball.
A little bit wide. It's a full count to Bobby Abreu. Ortiz at 109 pitches. Walked only one, struck out five. Make that six. And as Abreu goes down swinging, two down here in the eighth.
He's just had great command of that sinker to these left-handed batters. And this looked like another one. There it is. Look at that ball go down and away from Bobby Abreu. I mean, Ortiz right now knows that his mistake, really, in the seventh inning, is the game right now.
The bunt.
Yep.
Probably would have scored one, but
yeah,
two,
right,
in that inning, had he taken the out at first base.
Yeah, the odds are they'd have. I think they would have played the infield back if they got the bunt down. You don't know.
One one to Burrell. Burrell has flied out all three times that he's been up. Pat looking for his first ever hit against this right-hander Ortiz. He is 0 for 11 against Russ. Two and one to Burrell. Slam, but foul. Two balls and two strikes. Hills lead 2-1. We are in the bottom half of the eighth inning.
John Vukovich was kidding Burrell before the game. He says, will you do me a favor? He says, after you maim me with one of those, will you take care of my family? Burrell says, yeah, man, I almost got you last night, didn't I? I mean, he hits him so hard down there.
High drive into center field. It's deep, but it's going to stay in the park. Kenny Lofton in front of the warning track, and that'll retire the side. No runs, hits, errors, and none left. We go to the ninth inning. Jose Mesa time, Phils 2, Giants 1. On the Toyota National League scoreboard, Cincinnati in 13 over the Dodgers, 6-4, a two-run home run by Ken Griffey Jr. in the 13th. In that game, Eric Gagne and Jim Tracy, Dodger manager, were ejected in the ninth inning by Darren Hyosagna. Cubs came back to beat San Diego 8-7. Montreal, a 2-1 winner over the Arizona Diamondbacks. Kurt Schilling thwarted in his effort to try to win his 19th. Vladimir Guerrero, game-winning home run in the ninth inning, number 28 for Vlad. Colorado has a 3-0 lead on Pittsburgh in the ninth inning. Behind Jason Jennings, Florida is shutting out St. Louis 3-0 in the eighth. That's A.J. Burnett. Houston 3-1 over the New York Mets in the eighth. Craig Biggio is homer. Roy Oswalt is pitching for the Stros. And Atlanta shutting out Milwaukee 3-0 behind Greg Maddux in the seventh. Here it is 2-1 Phillies, and Jose Mesa comes on to try to close this one out for Randy Wolf. Mesa appearing in his 53rd game, 3 wins, 6 losses, 29 saves, 3.29 ERA. He'll face Reggie Sanders. Just missed, 1-0 to Sanders. Sanders has fly to deep right, grounded out, and struck out. Now is this one back and out of play?
Russ Ortiz, if Phillies win this game, he will get credit for a complete game here tonight. Did an outstanding job. Randy Wolf, Terry Adams, a little bit better to this point.
One and one to Sanders. One ball and two strikes. Save leaders, John Smoltz with 39, Eric Gagne with 35, Mike Williams has 32, and Mesa's fourth with 29. Base hit center field, Reggie Sanders.
No run for Sanders, he limps down the line with that leadoff hit. Fastball right down the middle. And Goodwin, who can really run, will come out and run for it. Here it is. There's a fastball. Jose got it in the middle of the plate. And look who's coming up.
Now Barry Bonds is coming up with a runner at first base. So it almost forces Larry Bowa to pitch to him. If that runner, of course, was at second base, he wouldn't. With a runner at first base, Bonds is brought out by Dusty Baker.
Here's Barry Bonds last night as he lined that home run off Mike Timlin into the bullpen. It doesn't get any easier because JT Snow is out there to bat for Martinez. So you knew all these left-handed hitters were available in this inning. Here we go. 3 home runs career as a pinch hitter for Bonds, and there's Snow.
Barry Bonds batting at 349, 29 homers. He has knocked in 63. Wonderful. Goodwin's not going to go anywhere.
Nope. And unless you throw it to the backstop.
Yeah.
And that would be another case of would you walk and put the winning run on first base. And Bowa would be faced with that as Dusty Baker works on his card.
One ball and no strikes to Barry Bonds.
Career against Mesa. And, of course, now they do get Nan up in the bullpen just in case they need it. There he is.
Missed 2-0.
That's the other thing about Bonds. I mean, he hardly ever swings at a bad ball. Phillies, you know, you'd like a double play, but they want an out more than anything. So Marlon Anderson is playing in the outfield in right field. Jimmy Rollins is up the middle.
Slices it to left field, and fortunately for the Phils, it is a foul ball. That's the last place you expect him to hit the ball.
Did it last night.
He got one of his doubles last night there.
Oh, it just disappeared. Look how close it was.
Wow.
6 inches maybe.
Wow. Very, very close. 2 balls and a strike to Bonds.
Close to second and third, and nobody out. There's Ortiz with LeVon Hernandez.
Ball is loose in the outfield. Bobby Abreu will chase it down.
See, where Marlon Anderson's playing, if Barry Bonds hits a ball on the ground, they can't get a force out with a guy like Goodwin at first base. But they're basically saying they're trying to stay away from a hit by Bonds to get a first and third.
Two and one to the pinch hitter, Barry Bonds. Jammed him and he fouls it back and out of play. It's two balls and two strikes.
You know, just certain hitters make you do different things. This is a situation we play for double play a lot of times, but you can't hit.
Two and two to Bonds. Up over our heads and in the upper deck, still two and two.
There are hitters in baseball that scare you every time they swing. And there's one of them. Might have been ball three, but it looked pretty good to him. Bonds has always been more of a high ball hitter than a low ball hitter, too, for a left-handed batter.
Count.
Great idea. Tried to backdoor him and fool him. Maybe he'd freeze. He did freeze, but the pitch is low.
Jeff Kemp waiting on deck.
No, it's Snow.
Oh, it's Snow. I'm sorry. JT Snow waiting on deck. Runner goes, Grotte should get an out. Marlon Anderson throws Bonds out, so they got the out. Goodwin moves up to second, but they got the man they wanted, Barry Bonds, one down here in the ninth inning.
Here comes Larry Bird. See, that's a double play ball if you play a normal defense, but they did not because they had to play that defense on Bonds, and they wind up with an out. Here's the pitch sequence to him. Good block by Lieberthal, another fastball. Fouled that one off. Fouled another one off. High fastball he fouled off. Tried the backdoor breaking ball. And then a fastball down the middle, and he smokes that. And it's a dead double play ball if you're playing for it. And they weren't. But how do you know?
They get Bonds out as Bo and Mesa talk it over about JT Snow. Snow has very good numbers against Jose Mesa. He is 8 for 16 lifetime, a 500 career hitter.
And the other left-handed hitter available, Ryan Miner, now moves into the on-deck circle to bat for Ortiz. There he is. So right now, Dusty Baker using all his left-handers off the bench that did not play tonight with Randy Wolf on the mound. You got to watch Goodwin. That might have been what that conversation was about when Boa went out there. Don't forget about Tom Goodwin, a great base stealer on at second base, and to take a look at him. It looks like Jimmy Rollins has a responsibility to come in behind him.
One ball and no strikes to Snow.
And you notice Jose is looking back there a lot.
Two and nothing. Snow hitting at 242. As a pinch hitter, he is 2-for-8 this year. Miss Ortiz, who went 8 innings. And Boas playing. I don't know who he was pointing, yelling out to, I think.
He's just making sure that they don't forget about him back there when it's 2-0.
Three balls and no strikes. Boone at second base. Phillies lead by a run, 2-1 here in the ninth inning. One out. Three balls and a strike. Two men on base, one out for Minor.
David Minor, a pretty good player this year for them. He's come out of nowhere to do a good job at first base, get a lot of at-bats, has some power, big guy.
Hitting at 254, 10 homers, he has knocked in 21. 4-for-21 as a pinch hitter.
Brother of Ryan Minor, who played in the major leagues, and also I think was a 76er draft pick at one time.
So Mesa pitching in a jam once again. He got out of a jam last night. Out of a bases loaded jam. Now he's got to get out of another one.
They will play in double play depth.
One strike to Minor.
Marlon Anderson will play deeper than Rollins. And, you know, if they get one, that's fine. Two would end the game, obviously, and be the best thing they can do. But they don't want to allow a base hit on that right side. So you see Marlon's a little deeper. Job by Mason. Let's not forget about Goodwin, who would then be the tying run if he got the third with less than two outs. One of these guys that hits in that open stance and then closes.
Tremendous drive into deep center field, but Glanville right in front of the fence makes the catch. Goodwin tags it. He'll go to third after the catch. But it stays in the park for out number two, runners at first and third.
Well, he hit it any other place, and that's trouble.
That might have been trouble earlier in the game,
yeah,
too.
The way it was carrying, right. I mean, Minor thought he might have had a home run there to dead center as he looks anxiously at it. I can imagine what they were doing in the Phillies dugout. But now Jimmy Rollins gets his fall, and Goodwin a little late tagging and a little bit of an errant throw. There's Goodwin running back to tag up. I mean, that great speed makes it. Now a lot of pressure on the catcher, Mike Lieberthal, now with a guy like Goodwin at third base.
Runners at first and third, two outs, ninth inning. Kenny Lofton is 1-for-3 with a walk.
Ed Minor just missed that.
Strikes.
A lot of pressure in your infield defense right now because of the speed of Lofton. This pitch is close. It's inside.
I think we recall talking it over with Jose Mason. Waiting on deck. On the outside corner, a good fastball. 1-1 the count to Kenny Lofton.
First pitch fastball in, this pitch on the outside corner.
Yeah. lift him up, should be the ball game. Marlon Anderson squeezes it. Jose Meza with his 30th save of the year. The Phillies hang on to win it 2-1 here at Veterans Stadium and take 2 out of 3 from the San Francisco Giants.
That's the first time they've won a series from them since 96.
Really?
Yep.
Wow. It has been a while. Phillies win their first series against the Giants since 96. Winning tonight 2-1. It wasn't easy, but they got it done. Randy Wolf is our Chevrolet player of the game. What a job he did tonight. Randy gave up just the one run in his 7 innings of work. He struck out 5. And the Phillies finally managed to get him a couple of runs in the 7th inning to win over the San Francisco Giants 2-1 here at Veterans Stadium.
They beat them a series here last year. That was at San Francisco. They hadn't won a series since 96, but it seems like they never win against the Giants. Great camaraderie there between those old foes, Dusty Baker and Larry Boa, John Vukovich. And that's the last time they'll see the Giants this year.
The season series ends dead even at 3 games apiece as the winning Phillies win 2 out of 3 here. Larry Boa wishing Dusty Baker well. As they part, the Pirates will be going to Pittsburgh and the Phillies will host the Dodgers. We'll be back with more right after these messages.
Hey, Ray.
Back at Veterans Stadium, the Phillies edge the Giants 2-1 for the winning Phils. 2 runs, 6 hits, an error, and 5 left. San Francisco, a run, 6 hits, no errors. They left 9. Randy Wolf, the winner. He is 7-7. Russ Ortiz takes the loss, 7-8. Jose Meza, his 30th save. Phils trailed 1-0. Going into that 7th inning, and a lot of good things happened for the Phils, and not so good for the Giants.
Right, Harry. Well, they put a couple men on base, and that was tough enough for the Phillies against Ortiz. Good job by Giambi. Fights off a slider for a base hit. Mike Lieberthal right up the middle under Ortiz's glove. Our Budweiser play of the game. Polanco gets the bunt down. Pinch runner Doug Glanville beats the play at third. They load him up. And then Marlon Anderson with a fielder's choice RBI. That tied the game. And then Travis Lee is a pinch hitter. A sinker ball. Jeff Kent comes home. Lieberthal with a good walking lead beats the play. And the Phillies behind Jose Meza's save in the 9th inning. Win a series against the San Francisco Giants. They beat them 2 out of 3 here last year, 2 out of 3 here this year.
Need help to put it out. First, I must slow it down.
Certainly not this introverted, you know, pocket protector wearing, computer geek.
He's a nerd. But he's a cool nerd. He definitely is a cool nerd.